हेलो फ्रेंड्स, मायसेल्फ मनीषा रामकृष्ण पटेल, असिस्टंट टीचर एट एचआर पटेल जूनियर कॉलेज शिवपुर. आई एम टीचिंग टू जूनियर कॉलेज 11 साइंस एंड 12 साइंस मैथमेटिक्स फ्रॉम प्रीवियस 20 इयर्स. नाउ टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू 11th standard mathematics paper first and chapter first, that is angle and its measurement. Before this, you know all the basic concepts of angles, as types of angles, definition of angles, types of angles, measurement of angles, that is right angle, obtuse angle, acute angle. Again, you take the corresponding measurement of angle by using the protractor. Again, you take the degree measurement of angle. Up to 10th standard, you learn all these concepts depending on the just revision of topic angle. And for according to syllabus of 11th standard, you take that angles produce measurement in some direction. So magnitude and direction, there are two concepts for this. And therefore, we take amount of angle is the measurement, and in the corresponding direction we take its sign. So magnitude of the angle with the sign, that concept is learned here. So for this case, we take here first angle, that is directed angle, or you may take that proposition directed angle. Directed angle, its name itself indicates the concept. Directed means direction. Angle can be written by some direction. So you know angle is the set of points. Angle is the set of two co-initial rays. Means we take two initial rays, two rays with the common initial point, and therefore region bounded by two rays with the common initial point. That region indicates the angle. But here we take that angle is the directed angle, means we have to show the direction for this. So always take here that directed angle is the combination of two rays, that is initial ray and terminal ray, or we may call that is initial R or terminal R. Suppose you can take here first this vertex is O and initial R is OA. Now this initial R is OA, then we can rotate this OAR through this vertex, that is the point O. That point is called vertex, in upward direction or downward direction. In upward direction means we call anticlockwise, in downward direction means clockwise direction. But that initial ray may be of this type, but initial ray may be of this type. You may take this is also initial ray. So depending on the position of initial ray, we take this rotation, that may be clockwise or anticlockwise. Now here we take this OA be the initial ray. Now this initial ray rotated through the vertex O up to the point, up to the second ray, that is O. So this is terminal ray. Now rotation of initial ray up to OB. So we can denote this by the direction of this. So OA to OB, rotation of initial ray through the vertex O up to OB, that form angle AOB, and that angle can be represented by ordered pair of ray OA and terminal ray OB. So we denote ray OA to ray OB by taking this arrow, or we can write this as ray OA, ray OB, or you may take initial ray OA and second terminal ray OB. Now in the case we take in a for the directed angle, in angle notation we take this direction. Suppose you can take measurement of that angle as reading of that angle from vertex ABA, BOA, its direction is changed. So for this case we can take same angle, but only we can write here that notation for this BOA. So this is read from terminal A, BOA. So depending on the direction of the order pair of initial ray and terminal ray, we take the corresponding directed angle. From this directed angle, remember that always we take first pair, first ray is initial ray. So for this is initial ray and this is called terminal ray. Or called initial R or terminal R. Now we take position from OA to OB. Suppose you can take same angle by taking initial ray OA, and here you mean that angle from B, B OA. So we get direct, we take direction is this, but both angle have same angle. Suppose this angle is theta degree. So again we take that angle have same angle theta degree. Both have same measurement, but we cannot say that directed angle AOB is equal to directed angle BOA. Both have same measurement, but their direction is different. So we cannot say their magnitude. They are two same directed angle. So for directed angle, always defined by the order pair, and in order pair we cannot change this pair. If the pair is changed, in that order pair is not equal to each other. OA, OB, that ray can be changed OB, OA. Here we can denote that directed angle BOA, the order pair, initial ray OB and terminal ray OA. You may denote this arrow or you may take simple, that is bar notation, or you say that is initial ray and terminal ray. So that measurement of angle and direction of the corresponding. At on this measurement and direction, there are, we take sign of the measurement of this, means we take positive angle and negative angle. So positive angle means, measurement of the directed angle. Positive angle means for the directed angle, the rotation of initial ray through the vertex O up to terminal ray in the anti-clockwise direction. Anti-clockwise direction means we take positive angle is the measurement of the corresponding angle OB. Because we take OA is the initial ray and measure up to OB. So this direction is according to anti-clockwise. So anti-clockwise measurement of the directed angle use always positive angle, and that of negative angle, negative angle is reverse of this. So in negative angle we can take directed angle with the initial ray rotated in the clockwise direction up to terminal ray. Now this is, suppose initial ray is OB. So this initial ray OB is rotated to the vertex O up to OA. We apply this terminal ray, but this direction of measurement is this, that is clockwise. And therefore we say this is the negative angle. So for negative angle, we take direction of rotation is always clockwise. And for negative angle, and for positive angle, this is anti-clockwise, and for negative angle, this is clockwise. So you take measurement. Suppose this theta, let's take measurement of that angle is 30 degree. And here we take measurement of angle is again 30 degree. But when we write actual measurement of this angle, so measurement of this directed angle AOB is equal to positive 30 degree or only we write 30 degree. But that of measurement of this directed angle BOA is equal to negative 30 degree, because we can measure the direction as in clockwise. So that is the difference between positive angle and negative angle. Now we take one complete rotation. So for this, before this rotation we take angle having measurement 0 degree, 180 degree, 90 degree. Already you are familiar with the angle which is right angle, measurement the angle less than right angle, that is acute angle. Again, angle having measurement is greater than right angle, that is obtuse angle. So for this, actually we take one complete rotation. So meaning of this one complete rotation means you take any initial ray and that can be rotated to this vertex. Suppose this is initial ray O. That can be rotated to the vertex O. Then rotation may be clockwise or anti-clockwise, but then OA rotated. coincident with each other. Coincident with each other means OA is OA rotated to the vertex O such that measurement of the angle is 360 degree and therefore the terminal ray is exactly coincident with the initial ray. So that measurement is 9. Suppose you take this initial ray and you take that complete one rotation like this. In sequence way, as we take, this is OA in the initial ray. So this is one complete rotation, but direction of measurement is this. Direction of measurement is this. Here, direction is anti-clockwise, so we take positive measurement. The direction is clockwise, so we take measurement is negative. So this is one complete rotation that gives measurement of angle 360 degree, and this is one complete rotation that gives measurement of angle minus 360 degree because we take the direction of rotation of the initial ray up to terminal ray. Here initial and terminal ray are coincident. Now we measure this angle from the direction as clockwise. So its measurement is minus 360 degree and that of same angle. Suppose we move from initial ray to terminal ray through the vertex O, coincident with the terminal ray, coincident of the initial ray to terminal ray. Now this measurement is from clockwise direction. This is the anti-clockwise direction. So we take that angle is plus 360 degree and this is the clockwise direction. So that angle of measurement minus 360 degree. So one complete rotation of angle gives measurement angle minus 360 degree or plus 360 degree. But for this angle we take initial ray rotate through the vertex O through an angle of 360 degree such that terminal ray coincident with itself. So OA and OB are coincident for this. And depending on this, as the measurement is 0, here we take one complete rotation is 360 degree is the one complete rotation, measure of the one complete rotation. But we take there is no rotation. So that can be fine, 0 and so we take only initial ray. Only initial ray OA, there is no any rotation, means initial and terminal ray are coincident, means second point B on the terminal ray, which is the image of A, but there is no terminal ray another, means angle having no any rotation, no any terminal ray, initial and terminal ray are coincident, such an angle of measurement of 0 degree or 0. Now we take in the next topic, we take the units of angles are different. So that angle have no rotation with initial ray and terminal ray. It is called zero angle. Now for this initial and terminal are coincident. As we take its magnitude is 0 degree. So first define magnitude, second define direction. Now with the help of this we will take a straight angle. Once you can define one complete rotation, then you can part, you can take number of parts of this one complete rotation. 0 degree means 1/4 of 360 is right angle, exact half of the 360 is 180 degree angle, that means a straight angle. Now for straight angle we can take again initial ray OA. Then we have to find straight angle. How we can define straight angle is the angle such that if OA is the initial ray, then it can be rotated in anti-clockwise direction up to OB, or it can be rotated through the clockwise direction up to OB. Suppose we can take this measurement. This is the anti-clockwise direction. That measurement of angle is plus 180 degree, and this is the clockwise measurement of angle. That measurement of the angle is 180 degree. Means in straight angle, rotation of initial ray through the vertex O up to terminal ray OB to an angle of 180 degree. That may be in positive, or that may be in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Again, both initial and terminal ray are exactly opposite direction. So this is the measure of straight angle with 180 degree plus or minus. Now right angle, we move this again. This is the 1/4 of measure of the one complete rotation. 1/4 measure of 120 rotation, that angle is called right angle. Now we take next angle, which are very important to learn the concept of mathematics for the paper with the measurements. So after this, you know the measurement of the angle and direction of the angle, but here we take very important angle, that is four terminal angle. Now, four terminal angle is in a cone is common and terminal is terminal ray. Suppose we draw here angle, now take a division ray OA. By using protractor, we draw here angle of measurement 30 degrees. So, we get terminal ray OB. So, this is a directed angle having measurement of 30 degrees because we measure clock anti clockwise direction. Now, for this angle AOB, we take terminal ray is common, terminal ray is common, but before this we can take concept of its initial ray. So in general, we take direct four terminal angles are the angles having different measure but common initial as well as terminal ray. Now same angle that can be measured in clockwise direction. So we get that measurement is for one complete rotation is 30 degrees less, so we get that is -330 degrees. In the same angle, only we can take direction of measurement is opposite, means in clockwise. So clockwise measurement is the negative angle, and this external angle measurement of that angle is nothing but 330 degrees, and therefore angle having measurement AOB, from AOB we take this is -330 degrees. And same angle AOB having measurement of 30 degree. Only depending on this direction, because both are opposite to each other. So angle having measurement 30 degree and -330 degrees, both are coterminal angles of each other. Means we take then these angles are the multiples, integral multiples of 360 degrees. For this we take again, suppose we take one complete rotation. This is one complete rotation. For 360 degrees, one complete rotation is the 360 degrees, and we draw angle here. Now from this we take, this is the measurement of angle, suppose 360 degrees. We take this measurement up to 360 degrees. Now add this 30 degrees here. Up to this you get an angle of 360 degrees, and this 30 degrees is 390 degrees. Now we take nature of the angle AOB, and here you may take A dash, O dash, B dash. This angle of measurement of 390 degrees. So angle having measurement of 30 degrees and angle having measurement of 390 degrees. We take just their nature is same. So that angle of measurement of 30 degrees. Their nature is same, but only we can indicate here one complete rotation by using this direction. Actually, this direction is similar. So angle having different measure, but same angle having different measure, but same initial and terminal ray. That angles are called coterminal angles. These angle can be repeated again here too. Means we take rotation and again this one rotate this. First rotation and up to this. So this is 30 degree and this up to again 30 plus 360 means say 90 degree. Or you take again in reverse direction also that angle. Measurement of that angle in reverse direction which is -330 degrees. So for four terminal angles, these are the most important angles, because for next chapter is for trigonometry. We take trigonometric ratios for any angle. Angle having any measurement. Up to 10 standard you learn only the trigonometry. A ratio having the measurement of angles up to 90 or 180 degrees, but we take a measurement of any angle and by construction of any angle on the plane. So suppose here we can draw the angle having measurement of 720 degrees. So we draw for this, so we take that angle by using the Cartesian plane system. You know that a complete one circle is defined in this way. So one complete rotation is 360, but 720 is a multiple of 360, so second multiple. So you can show this. One complete rotation 360, again continuing at an angle in measurement of 720 degrees, because measurement of direction is again anti-clockwise, so that angle of measurement of 720 degrees. Means we draw angle having any measurement that depends on its side. Suppose this side is negative, so same angle can be measured in clockwise direction. So its sign and its magnitude, according to this, we draw that angle in which quadrant its cardinal ray lies. That depends on the nature of the angle. So remember that here, coterminal angles having common initial and terminal ray. Next, that angle have same initial terminal ray but different measure. And secondly, here, so question on this and determine which of the following pair implies coterminal angles. So for this case, you can take the differences of these two angles is always integral multiple of 360 degree. Means you take 390 and 330 degree. What is difference of this? 360 degree. Suppose you can take one complete rotation, second complete rotation, and again this add one complete rotation. That is, instead of 330, we take here 750. Means 2 complete rotation is 720 plus 30, that is that angle becomes 750. So 750 and first angle is 30. What is their difference? 720. So again 720 can be written as 2 times 360. So again if we take that angle having reverse measure, that is minus 330. So take out their difference. 30 minus 330 degree, again that minus becomes here plus, that addition is 360 degree. Means you take any pair, coterminal, any pair which represent coterminal angle, so their difference is always integral multiple, means sometimes they can be positive or negative, means plus or minus, integral multiple of 360 degree, then that angles are called coterminal angles. Now after this, we take the concept of standard angles. Standard angles, and after this we take two types of the standard angles. Angle quadrantal angles and angle in quadrant. Angle in quadrant. Angle quadrantal angle. This is very simple concept of angles by the Cartesian coordinate system. We take here plane of axis x to x times and y to y times. Point of intersection of these two rays as O, that is origin. Now, in standard position is we take here inclination always along positive direction of x axis. First, we define standard angles. So, standard angles are angles which are directed angle, and in this case always we take initial ray is fixed, which is always along positive direction of x axis. If there is condition only on initial arc or initial ray, not on terminal ray. Standard angles are the directed angles in which initial arc is always along positive x axis. So its terminal ray, you will take that is in first quadrant, or in second quadrant, or in third quadrant, or in fourth quadrant. Or that may be lies along positive y-axis, negative x-axis, negative y-axis. Means there is no question about its terminal, that may be in the plane, but only condition of initial. For standard angle, always initial ray is along positive direction of x-axis. Now, for this, from this, for this terminal ray, there are two types of the standard angle, that is angle in quadrant and quadrantal angle. Angle in quadrant means we take a particular quadrant, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. So you know that names, quadrant numbers 1, 2, 3, 4. Now we take, suppose this is the first angle, XOP or AOP. Now second, AOQ. Now third AO, R. Now this is O, AO, S. So we may take in reverse direction also. So these angles, means we define angle in first quadrant. Angle in first quadrant is the standard angle whose terminal ray lies in first quadrant. Angle in second quadrant, angle which is standard but terminal ray lies in second quadrant. Angle in third quadrant means standard angle in which the terminal ray lies in third quadrant. And lastly, angle in fourth quadrant, its terminal ray is standard angle whose terminal ray lies in fourth quadrant. So by using the corresponding quadrant number, we can define angle in particular quadrant. Now these quadrantal angles are again standard angles, but here condition for terminal ray change means again quadrantal angles are the standard angles whose terminal ray lies along quadrantal axis. Quadrantal axis means we take coordinate axis. Means suppose OA is the initial ray, so the second terminal ray. Suppose we take here angle AOB is the quadrantal angle. Angle AOC is the quadrantal angle. Angle AOD is the quadrantal angle. Angle AOA, or you may take here E, which is coincident with that OA. So again that angle is angle of measurement complete 360 degree or 0 degree. That angle is again quadrantal angle. So remember that these quadrantal angles are multiples of 90 degree, because we take this is pi by 90 degree, then this is 180 degree, then this is 360 degree, 270 degree, and complete one rotation is 360 degree measurement. So quadrantal angles are the integral multiple of 90 degree. Now this 90 degree can be measurement about pi by 2. We learn this is a measurement of 60 degree. So 90 degree is measurement of one right angle, and the whole quadrantal angles are multiples, integral multiples of 90 degree. Integral multiples means we take that may be positive or negative, because that depends on the measurement of angles. That may be direction in clockwise or anti-clockwise. So we see all these are the types of directed angles, means from we start from directed angles as 0 angle, straight angle, one rotation angle, next quadrantal angle, then standard angle, and quadrantal angle, and the quadrant. Now these are the only measurements with the direction, but how will you measure the angle? Up to 10 standard, you know that unit of measurement of angle is only degree. But actually there are two systems of measurement of angles. Sexagesimal system of measurement of angle, and second is the circular system. So measurement of angle means amount of angle, or we can measure the rotation of initial ray up to terminal ray in the clockwise or anti-clockwise. So that amount of angle is nothing but the measurement of angle. So sexagesimal system, up to 10 standard you are familiar with the sexagesimal system, because in this system unit of measurement of angle is degree. Unit of measurement of angle is degree. So how you can define degree? So before this, you know this is one complete rotation having measurement of 360 degree. Now this measurement along the circle, as we take this is the circle, and for this circle we take measurement of one complete rotation of 360 degree. Suppose this is initial ray, and this complete circle is one 360 degree measurement, means we can divide these 360 equal parts of one complete rotation, and then one part of that rotation gives the 1 degree measurement. 1 degree is nothing but if one complete rotation of circle is divided into 360 equal part. 360 equal part. Then each sub part gives a measurement of 1 degree. So 1 degree is 1 by 360 the part of 1 rotation. 1 rotation. So degree is the unit of measurement for sexagesimal system. But after this we again take second unit and third unit. Second unit is 1 minute. 1 minute is nothing but 1 complete 1 degree. Suppose this time we have measurement of 1 degree. Again that 1 degree is divided by 60 equal part. It is divided in 60 equal part. Then each sub equal part is called 1 minute. Means 1 degree is divided. 1 degree is divided in 60 equal parts. Means 1 by 60th part of 1 degree. 1 by 60th part of 1 degree is nothing but 1 minute. And again, next unit is 1 second. 1 second is nothing but 1 minute is again divided by into 60th equal part. Then 1 60th part of 1 minute is called 1 second. For minute we take only 1 dash and for second we take 2 dash. These are the units of measurement of sexagesimal system. In this system, degree is the biggest unit, after this we take minute and after this we take second. So by general calculation we get here, 1 rotation is equal to 360 degree measurement, 1 degree or 1 minute is equal to 1 degree is equal to 60 minutes, 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. By using this condition, we take 1 complete rotation is 360 degree measurement, 1 degree is equal to 60 minute and 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. But this is old system of measurement of angle. Now, there is new system of measurement of angle that is circular system. There are some drawbacks for the system of measurement of angle, which is sexagesimal system. Therefore, this system gives measurement of angle again related with the same circle. But here we take condition on the length of arc and corresponding measure of the angle. Now here we take it both be the center of the circle and this OA be the radius of the circle. We draw the circle having center and OA and radius is OA. So we take for the circular system, unit of measurement of angle is radian. Unit of measurement of angle is radian. So we can define one radian. Symbol for just a degree we take here 0, but here we take 1 radian is 1c. Or you cannot write this c symbol, you can write 1 radian. So, 1 radian is the measure of the central angle. Or with that angle is central angle. So, suppose we take this is the central angle. We call this angle of measurement of 1 radian. Where initial ray is OA and terminal ray is OB. But, condition on that, that arc which subtends that angle at the center of the circle, again have length is equal to radius. Means, 1 radian is the measurement of central angle such that the arc is subtends that angle, its length is equal to radius. So we take arc subtends angle at center of circle having length equal to radius. Angle length equal to radius means arc of length equal to radius. We subtend angle at center of the circle is always 1 radian. So suppose this radius is 5 units. Actually this radius is 5 units. So length of arc is also 5 units. Also we have second concept that if you can take concentric circle of this means having the center, same center, you draw the second circle. Suppose its radius, this biggest circle its radius is 5, this smallest circle whose radius is 3. Again this radius is 3, again this radius is 3. If this length of arc is 3 units, so measurement of angle is same. Again, you take outer circle for them, same circle which is the concentric. Now we take that radius is 10 units and elongate this OA and OB. Did I have to circle which draw external side of the circle? Now center is fixed, only radii are different. Means radii having unit of 10 units and second radius is also 10 units. But we take that length of arc is again 10 units when center angle is wanted. So you can draw here number of circles concentric to given circle having different radii, but you take measurement of center angle is 1 radian as we draw number of circles. Means that measurement of center angle, which is 1 radian, is independent on radius. Means we draw number of circles which are concentric with a given circle having different radii, but measurement of center angle is never changed if the arc length is equal to radius which subtends that angle at the center of the circle. So radii measurement is independent of radius. For this you take again second concept is radian is constant. Radian measure is constant or radian is a constant. Radian is constant means for the circle we take concept, actually this is a theorem for radian measurement which is constant, and at the name of this we have to take conversion factor. Radian measure which can be converted into degree measure, and degree measure which can be converted into radian measure. Suppose for the circle, we draw a simple circle. For this circle, suppose we take here OB the center, P be another point, P and Q are any two points on the circle. Now we take radius of that circle is R, and length of this arc is R. P, P, Q, R, V, any three points on this circle, OP, OQ, OR, the radii of the circle. Now suppose we take central angle is 1 radian, and therefore length of R, PQ is again R. So length of R, PQ is equal to R, measurement of angle PO2 is equal to 1 radian. Now we take R is the point on the circle such that angle POR is right angle. Angle POR is equal to right angle is having measurement of 90 degree. Now again, for corresponding POR angle, we take length of R. So what is length of R? PR. So this is 1/4 part of circumference. 1/4 part of circumference. What is circumference of circle? 1 by 4 times 2 pi r. Circumference of the circle is 2 pi r. So 2 pi r upon 4, that is pi r by 2. Now from this we take relation as, you know that measurement of the central angle, the measurement of central angle is directly proportional to the corresponding length of r. That concept you already learned in 10th standard. Measurement of central angle is directly proportional to the length of R which subtends that angle. So by using this concept, measurement of angle POQ, measurement of angle POR, which is proportional to corresponding length of R PQ, and here length of R PR. So by using this relation, we get that radian measurement is constant. See what is measurement of angle POQ? That is 1 radian. Measurement of angle POR, which is equal to right, 1 right angle or radian 90 degree, is equal to here R, and length of R, pi R by 2. Pi R by 2. Now take simplification for radian measurement. 1 radian is equal to, here this R is cancelled, divided by 2 is we take 2 pi pi, and this right angle is multiplied here. It is 2 by pi times right angle. 2 by 5 times 1 radian is equal to here r r cancel 1 upon pi by 10 is 2 upon pi and this 1 times 9 angle is equal to the right side which is multiplying so 2 times 9 angle divided by pi so that 1 radian gives as 2 is constant measurement of right angle is constant and pi is constant so meaning of this whole term is constant you can do 1 radian is constant so radian measurement of angle is constant in another way we get again that second result 1 radian is equal to 2 times what is measurement of right angle in degree measurement of right angle in degree that is 90 degree whole divided by pi whole divided by pi is pi from the length x we take the circumference 2 pi now after cross multiplication we get equation pi radian is equal to 180 degree. This is the most important reason for the relation between degree and radian. Degree measure can be converted into radian measure and radian measure can be converted into degree measure by using this reason. And therefore we get here two formulae as 1 radian is equal to 180 upon 5 degree and 1 degree is equal to pi upon 180 radian because let them multiply one coefficient 1 radian is pi is divided to a means you get any notation and for this here 1 degree is multiplied so 180 is shifted to that left side so pi upon 180 is 180 is shifted to this side pi upon 180 you get 1 degree so remember that always pi radian is equal to 180 degree and by using this we take the measurement of right angle obtuse angle or right angle, straight angle, one complete rotation, angle having measurement 30 degree, 60 degree, 45 degree in order to find the measurements of trigonometric ratios and therefore we take that measure of the angles in degree to radian and radian to degree. Now here this topic is over for measurement of angles. For next period I will take second topic of the chapter that is length of arc and area of sector. So thanks to all.